26 years ago, 18-year-old Heidi Marie Allen opened her workplace for the day. Then, she vanished into thin air. Heidi Marie Allen was born on September 14, 1975. She was employed as a clerk at the D&W convenience store located at the intersection of New York State Routes 104 and 104B in New Haven, New York. Heidi had to work that Easter morning in 1994. Her sister Lisa and the rest of her family were at home preparing Easter baskets. According to Lisa, Heidi was energetic and always smiling, a demeanor that she carried with her to work. In fact, Heidi wasn't even supposed to be working that day. She was filling in for a co-worker who wanted to spend the holiday with her kids, a proof that Heidi was a kind-hearted girl. According to Lisa, Heidi's sister, Lisa always put her friends first, friends and family first. That's just the way she was. On the morning of April 3, 1994, Heidi had opened up the store by herself at approximately 5:45 a.m. The last recorded transaction on the cash register was at 7:42 a.m. A passerby flagged down a sheriff's patrol unit outside the store at approximately 8:15 a.m. and reported that the convenience store was open. Both lights and gas pumps were on, but it was unattended. An extensive search produced few clues as to Heidi's whereabouts, and she has never been heard from again. An investigation revealed that Heidi was most likely taken against her will from the store. Her jacket, purse, and car keys were left behind in the store when she vanished. Her maroon station wagon was undisturbed in the parking lot, and money was found in the cash register and on the counter. So, hindi siya burglary gone wrong. The police thought that it's kidnapping because yung pera nandoon pa din. Meron pa kang pera sa counter. Heidi was about to graduate from college with a degree in human services when she disappeared, and she hoped to get a career in education or counseling. Richard Thibodeau was charged with Heidi's kidnapping in May 1994, a month after Heidi was last seen. Richard's brother, Gary Thibodeau, was arrested on the same charge in August 1994, 3 months later. Richard was the last customer known to be in the store before Heidi vanished. He says he purchased 2 packs of cigarettes at 7:30 a.m. and he left. Gary Thibodeau was convicted of first-degree kidnapping in Heidi's case in June 1995. And he was sentenced to 25 years to life in prison. Richard was acquitted of all charges in September 1995. Gary attempted to appeal his conviction, but he was denied in 1999. A witness saw 2 men leading a young woman into a van, but couldn't identify any of them. So this witness was not sure if it's Gary or Richard, the brothers, Gary and Richard Thibodeau, and if it's really Heidi. Kung yung babae ba na sinasakay sa van ay si Heidi talaga. So according to this witness, The men, supposedly Richard and Gary, put Heidi into Richard's white and black van, then drove to Gary's residence in Mexico, about 8 miles away. Another witness saw a two-tone van swerving through the village of Mexico with the driver apparently struggling with something behind him. Several neighbors reported seeing a white and black van parked in Gary Thibodeau's driveway that morning. Both Thibodeau brothers volunteered to help with Heidi's search effort before their arrests. Prior to Heidi's disappearance, Melissa Surlis, Heidi's cousin, gave her a gold bracelet with her name on it. Melissa stated the bracelet mysteriously turned up inside an envelope in her mailbox in 1994, so 10 years after Heidi's disappearance, but she didn't tell the police or anyone about it for years, and the reason for her silence are unclear. The authorities don't know why Melissa didn't tell them about the bracelet. Heidi's abduction got additional attention in the summer of 2014 when investigators dug up the floor of a collapsed cabin looking for her body. They didn't find anything in the search, however. Heidi's mother, Sue Allen, died in 2015 at the age of 66 on what would have been Heidi's 40th birthday. And according to Lisa, no parent should have to close their eyes not knowing where their child is. Ken Allen, Heidi's father, suffered a heart attack less than a year after Heidi's disappearance. Heidi was about 5'9 to 5'11. She was 145 pounds at the time of her disappearance. She was wearing a gray sweatshirt with a plaid SU logo imprinted on the front. She's wearing light blue jeans, size 9 or 10 white sneakers, and possibly an 18-inch gold chain necklace with a heart and diamond pendant. She has light brown hair, blue hazel eyes, and she has a 1-inch scar on her right knee and a freckle-type birthmark between her buttocks. Her ears are pierced, and she wears contact lenses or glasses with Renaissance metal frames. And then, an evidence surfaced. Evidence that included proof that Heidi Allen was actually acting as a confidential drug informant for the Oswego County Sheriff's Department. At the time, Heidi was acting as an informant, she would have been 15 or 16 years old. According to documents obtained by federal prosecutor Lisa Pebbles, Heidi's parents gave permission for her to be an informant. The information was never passed to Gary Thibodeau's defense lawyer. It was later learned that an index card containing Heidi Allen's personal information in picture used to identify her as a confidential informant was lost in the parking lot of the D&W convenience store by a sheriff's deputy. So, nalaglag sa isang sheriff deputy itong index card na to containing Heidi's information dun sa same store kung saan kinidnap supposedly si Heidi. So, according to the police, maybe someone na related sa illegal substances ang nakakita ng information na yon about Heidi. Or maybe a lot of people saw that index card and the police thought that maybe that's the reason why Heidi was abducted. So the new evidence surfaced when former Oswego County resident Tonya Priest came forward with information pertinent to the case. Tonya was flown to the county as a witness in the hearing. However, her testimony was canceled. Three men, James Thumperstein, Roger Breckenridge, and Michael Borer, are new suspects in the case. So itong tatlong lalaki daw na to is involved in illegal substances and illegal things. James Thumperstein is currently serving a life sentence for the murder of his estranged wife and her boyfriend. On the other hand, Gary Thibodeau maintained his innocence until he died at the age of 64 in 2019 from complications related to COPD, a lung disease. Gary had been in a hospice care for the past year in the hospital ward of the Coxsackie Correctional Facility in south of Albany. He recently lost his last chance state appeal to overturn his conviction in Heidi Allen's disappearance. He died less than 2 years away from his first possible parole hearing in January 2020. To this day, Heidi has still never been found, and she would have been 45 years old if she's still alive. If you have any information about this case, please contact the Oswego County Sheriff's Department at 888-349-3411 or 800-724-8477.